Welcome to another video from Beta CEA Systems. In this video, the new casting functionality will be presented, demonstrating how a casted part is prepared from start to finish in ANSA version 22. The casting algorithm runs better on clean geometries, so a geometry preparation precedes the run. Opening the feature manager and select it to recognize the logos and 3D holes, ANSA will return a list with the corresponding features. From there, design actions can be performed to remove logos or holes that are smaller than a given value. A geometry check verifies that the part has no errors and the middle surface can be extracted. All the necessary functions for the middle surface extraction can be found under the new middle mesh menu layout. The casting algorithm lies, together with the extrusion one, under the middle mesh generate function. On the first tab that comes up, the parameters regarding the middle mesh to be created are set. Switching to the features tab, 2D holes recognition is available, and specific treatment can be set depending on the hole size. Hitting OK and the algorithm starts running. After the algorithm finishes, the result is an FE cell mesh at the middle position of the initial solid description. This cell mesh is linked to the geometry by align constraints. By hiding the geometry faces and switching to the align draw mode, each macro area is colored according to its align constraint type. To check the accuracy of the result, the new inspect function is available. The inspect will compare the result to the initial geometry and mark the areas that need correction based on the values given in the options list. Select the whole model and hit middle mouse button to run. Wherever there is some missing mass is highlighted and the misplaced areas are colored depending on the error type. On the top left corner of the drawing area, there is a legend that describes the coloring scheme and allows the visibility of the results to be turned on and off. Knowing in which area to focus, the result can be easily improved with the use of the new Direct Edit functionality. With the Direct Edit activated, when the pointer hovers over an area, a preview of its align constraint is visible. A macro area can be added to another align constraint by drag and drop. Hitting Ctrl and left-clicking onto the highlighted areas, multiple selection is possible, and with a single drag and drop, all the macro areas are added to one. Stray hot points can be deleted by left-clicking on them. With a right-click, a window is prompt showing all the available functions of the corresponding entity. Select multiple to delete more than one hot point at once. Left-click on a perimeter to perform a join. With the Q key, the edit mode changes from areas to elements. Drag and drop nodes to paste. Right-click and select Delete to delete unnecessary elements. Switching back to the Areas mode, when a perimeter is joined between two areas, their align constraints are merged into one. A constraint can be changed or edited from the right-click menu. When hovering the pointer over a perimeter, the node's number can be increased with the key 2 or decreased with the key 1. The four-sided function is available on the right-click menu. Instead, the shortcut key V can be used for quicker access to the function. The same drag and drop action can be performed also to merge perimeter align constraints. With the shortcut key B, the improvement brush comes up and reconstruct can be applied locally where needed. By dragging from a hot point to an opposing perimeter, a cut is made. The number of nodes can be changed also from the right-click menu. When on the four-sided function, the shortcut keys 1 and 2 can be used to modify the numbers of nodes. For round areas, the circular mesh is available. A cut can be also made between more than one macro areas. All the previous improving actions can be quickly performed using only the shortcut keys and avoiding extensive clicking with the mouse. The shortcut for circular mesh is the key C. For joining more than one perimeter, instead of clicking one by one, the join multiple is available. After activating, multiple perimeters can be selected using box selection. Confirm with the middle mouse button to accept. The function is quickly activated using the shortcut key M. And the selection can include perimeters from more than one area of the model, allowing for massive actions to be performed in one. With a direct edit mode, while improving the constraint definitions, it is easy to quickly improve the mesh quality as well. Switching to the elements edit mode with the Q key, trias can be moved by drag and drop or completely removed if moved to the edge of the part. Opposing trias can be eliminated. Multiple perimeters can be selected and added to an align constraint. The constraint can be defined by the right-click menu. When turning the Inspect Visibility back on, the report gets updated and the remaining errors are shown. For bulk, rounded areas where the casting algorithm failed to produce a result, the O-Junction function helps to automatically recognize these areas and treat them appropriately. The unwanted areas are deselected with a right mouse click, and the Hexa Solid treatment is selected. When the algorithm is done, one final inspect is run on the whole model to make sure that no more improvements are required. And the model is ready. Thank you very much for watching this video.